Hi, this is Christine Calabrese. I'm just here to just talk to you quickly about what is leveled reading and then what are decodable texts. Classroom, you have a random set of books and you, the teacher, open up the book and look at it and say, okay, this is a level A, this is a level B, this is a level C, level D, level E. But they're not decodable necessarily. They're just, the teachers basically simply decide this text looks like it's going to be an easy reader, very easy, super easy for level. So the teachers have libraries in their classrooms with all these leveled readers, and they happily move their children along. I don't know how the children are decoding in these leveled readers, because there is no decoding instruction in the Lucy Calkins Reading and Writing Workshop, which is the model for most of the classrooms. A decodable reader. A decodable reader is decodable, which means every single word in that book the child can decode. In the Sing, Spell, Read, and Write program, in fact, we have the Raceway book. In the Raceway book, we have a list of words on the short A vowels. These are CVC words or CVCC words or CCVC words, and they are decodable, all in short A's. Then in the beginning of the book, Sue Dixon has a list of all the words, and then she has a couple of rule breaker words which she introduces. Now, in this program, only and only these words are used in the book. The book is long, it's robust, there's plenty of words in here for the child to decode, and they actually sound out or decode these words. Moving along in this program, the ebook, which is short A and short E words, focusing on the short E words, but A words are in here as well, so the child gets a review, comes sweeping back and gets a review. Then they have the short I book, but it's not just simply short I words. These are short I, short A, and short E words. Decodable readers are used in a systematic program. You can't just throw a book in front of a kid and expect them to read without teaching them how to read. And you have to have a system. If you don't have a system, I don't know what you're doing. You're just throwing a book in front of a kid and saying, read. I don't know how the kid's going to learn if you don't actually teach them. So this whole leveled library brought in by Lucy Calkins, who, by the way, has never taught any child to read. She was a writing teacher at a college, never even in elementary school, it's not giving the children anything. No word to text skills, no phonetic decoding skills whatsoever. These are the, what we call the basal readers, is from the balanced literacy approach. So this is a basal reader from Storytown. It was published in, I think, 2008, actually. And this book is the first book in a series of four hardcover books. Again, very flimsy, lack of practice in these books. You can see Pam can tag. Okay, so short A words. That's good. At least he's doing that. But then they move on really quickly and they start. I don't remember introducing anything phonetically here. And they have some words in here that I wouldn't even introduce to the children until they can actually decode. Here's another book in this balanced literacy approach, which I never found worked. And here we have big foxes juggle balls, pins, and little red foxes cannot catch the balls and pins. Well, here you have a whole bunch of words that if the children aren't taught how to decode, they're not going to be able to make it through this. Elephant tusks are long teeth. There's a lot of stuff in here. This is the 1-3 book. Again, this is towards the middle or end of first grade, supposedly. I never got there with these books ever. And finally, I have this wonderful book that I have from the 1990s. This was published in the 1990s. This is a really nice book, but my kids were never able to read this because they were never really taught in this balanced literacy program how to decode. So sadly, these books sat on the shelf, a lot of them. And this is the Make-A-Wish, and then the next one is A New Day, which is like amazing. The stories are really wonderful. But again, my kids couldn't even, they never could get there. With a decoding system, my children would use the decoding system, learn to read, and then pick up these books and read right through. Pick up any book and read right through. So what happens with my kids when they go to a leveled library? Who knows? The teacher doesn't know where to put them. She's going to put them in like K-L-M-N-O-P. The kids can read. They can read. Put any book in front of them and they can read. That's the whole point of phonics programs and programs that are direct, systematic, explicit. They're a total language program. They have the phonics in them. They have the reading in them. They have the spelling in them, the handwriting in them, everything built into the program. There aren't that many programs out there like that, but you can dig and find them. There's something called Super Kids, Logic of English, Sing, Spell, and Read, or Write. Those are my three top. Sing, Spell, and Read, or Write is, of course, my top. Have a great day, and thank you for listening. Bye-bye.
Unfortunately, Sing, Spell, Read, and Write is no longer published by Pearson. It was my favorite, but you can find good programs out there still, no doubt. Do your research, leave a comment below if you're enthusiastically using a program you like. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. Bye-bye.